The coronavirus pandemic is stretching healthcare systems globally. Funds are being pumped into hospitals in rich countries, and in many cases, it's still not enough. But there are lots of countries where healthcare systems are even less ready to take the strain. Countries like the Central African Republic, which has just 3 ventilators for a population of just under 5 million. In many lower income countries, there are huge levels of national debt. So much so that money that should be going to healthcare is instead going to debt payments. Lower income countries are due to spend $40 billion on debt payments in 2020 alone. The reasons behind the debt crisis faced by these countries are complex. Many countries are burdened because of unfair circumstances, higher interest rates, the systematic extraction of wealth, unfair trade rules, and irresponsible lending by Western banks, to name a few. And coronavirus has made the situation worse. Turmoil in global markets means that interest rates on future borrowing for these countries has increased even more. Campaigning together, we managed to get up to $12 billion of debt payments by Global South countries suspended, so countries could respond to the current crisis. But so much more is needed. We want to see debt payments cancelled altogether, so debt doesn't build up. This will allow the world's poorest countries to invest in healthcare in the face of coronavirus. We need an official bankruptcy process, so when countries get into debt problems, there's a fair way to get out. The IMF must stop incentivizing bad loans by bailing out private lenders when they can't be repaid. And the government must make sure no countries are sued through UK courts if they can't pay debts owed to private lenders. Acting now could stop almost 500 million people in lower income countries being pushed into poverty because of the crisis. 800,000 people have added their names to global petitions calling for debt cancellation. Let's put health before debt. Will you join us?